appeal to. So LinkedIn, there's a few, mostly students is the youngest age. So about 23 plus is the target audience on LinkedIn. And if you use other socials, make the choices you need to. Edie, if I come to you first, was that okay?
Sure. Well, I guess my philosophy is as far as dying and living well and dying well, is basically that, to live well and to die well, aside from the spiritual, emotional part of it, okay, is all about money. How much you can live and how much you can afford as far as when you die and et cetera. So I think that the emphasis for me is that number one, if I ever figure out a way to change our educational system so that I can contribute at least to educating children about finances from the very beginnings when they start school, which would be the ideal place and the most appropriate place for that to happen, I will do that. But short of that, I only can deal with what I can control. So for right now, my emphasis is on teaching my two grandchildren, who are in the 20-something age, teaching them about money. I have started already by buying 16 shares of Facebook when it went public, and having them watch how it goes up and down and et cetera and moves along. And now, because of what I've learned too late in some situations, I am, and because of what I know of my family, I'm helping them to prepare for their own finances, et cetera. And the potential of having to take care and help take care of their parents, my kids, okay, their parents, and in terms of some kind of insurances, et cetera, and other things for themselves, so that I'm helping them buy insurance for themselves so that they will have maybe cash value to help and assist their own parents, and if they need to, or whatever they need it for. Because I'm at the point in my age where I'm way past being able to do that for myself. I mean, expense-wise, nothing else. So I can only work with what I have and what I can control. And short of talking to other people about how important it is to plan ahead because time is your friend, then that's about all I feel like I can do. And I think that it is a big job. It's a big job to educate people about anything. And I think maybe a lot of the fear that people have around dying is because they have no control, of their life. And so that they don't have any con I mean, they know they don't have control over their dying, so that those two fears together may be what prevents them from taking
Causes a
action of
sort
any
of,
kind.
causes a sort of paralysis. And I think what's interesting is that you, so if you've had an experience as yourself, then you're not afraid because the reality kicks in and you can't be having the things that we imagine. People just go into a sort of problem-solving mode. Marilyn, as the organizer of this chat, tell whoever is going to be looking at you on video why they should talk to you about tying up their loose ends.